stuff. How you doing today? I'm Lee. So you can call me Leroy or Bruce Leroy or Nerd Boy or Hannibal. So I replaced this coolant bleeder valve housing on this 2004 Dodge Stratus. It's a 2.7 V6 using a lot of Chrysler and stuff. This is the third time it's been replaced because it's made out of plastic. It's the first time I did it myself. So here's the part, made in China, piece of junk. If they made them out of aluminum, you know, they might probably wouldn't have had to replace any of them. $40 from Jigs. And the part goes right here. And obviously you've got your temperature sensor plugs in here. And the four screws, you have to, there's other clips that show how to do this. I'm just going over what I learned from this. You do have to loosen the intake up. I had to get to this screw right here. It's the hardest one to get to. So I replaced it. It was leaking. Everything went well, except it was running a little bit too warm. And that really had me stumped and ticked off. I kept opening the bleeder, letting air out. I decided to replace, use a regular hose clamp on the upper radiator hose. I think they're a little bit easier to deal with. So what I did was hook up my aftermarket better temperature gauge. It actually has numbers on it instead of just hot and cold. So I did that and it was still running warm. It was like 200 and at least 210 or higher degrees. A little bit warm for this time of year. So I plugged the aftermarket temperature gauge into my heater hose here with a 3/8 pipe thread T that you can get at any hardware store. And that works great. So I was trying to figure out what the deal was, and obviously I thought, what else did I change? Well, the new one came with a new temperature sensor. So guess what, ladies and gentlemen? I put the old sensor back in, and eureka, everything's back to normal. So, you know, I don't know why in the world this new one caused it to run so much hotter. I mean, it would warm up quick. I'm thinking about saving this to use when it's really cold in the wintertime. Just wanted to let anybody know that might be a problem that might save you some headache and some time and frustration, because it had me stumped for 2 or 3 weeks I was driving it like that. So I'm going to show you one more thing about the interior. And see if I can get this. Didn't mean for this clip to go this long. On this car, obviously the geniuses couldn't put any numbers on the temperature gauge. It's either hot or cold. And for me, it always ran about a quarter of the way up all the time. I mean, it would get a little warmer closer to the middle, halfway, when you're stuck in traffic in the summertime. So with my aftermarket gauge, it's not warmed up right now. Here's the what it's telling me. When this thing is about a quarter of the way up or just a little less, it is right on 195, 200 degrees. Dead nuts, baby. So just keep that in mind. Now you know that. And I think I've said enough. Hope that helps somebody.